So welcome. My name's Chris Izor. If I haven't personally met you, I am the director of LCAP Advisory Services here at our Santa Clara County Office of Ed, and we are really excited to be able to have you all here today. The energy in this room feels great. It's full. We've got a full day of content for you. But before I go any further, I'd like to bring up our division assistant superintendent, Dr. Gary Waddell. He is our assistant superintendent of our Equity and Educational Progress Division, just to share a welcome with you.
Thank you. Good morning. I am Gary Waddell, and I just want to welcome you this morning. It is great to see everyone at the start of 2020 as we reboot our not only this work, but everything else it feels like these days. So we are really excited to have you here today, and I bring greetings on behalf of County Superintendent Dr. Marianne DeWan, who couldn't be with us this morning, but sends her best wishes for a great day of learning and collaboration. So we're really excited to have you. This has been a journey, really, this LCAP work for us since 2014 when this work began. And we know it hasn't been without its challenges along the way, but we really have this ethic that in partnership we can leverage this work to make a difference in the lives of students across the county and across the state. We've really, as you know, last year reformed our commitment to this work and the way we thought about this work, the team that we brought together. And our commitment really is to have a team of highly skilled experts that work in partnership with you, that don't do to you, but do with you, and are there standing beside you, working through the easy parts and the hard parts of this. We've had the opportunity to be very involved at the state level as well as this new template. You know, since 2014, this revision is the most substantive that has occurred. And next week, the state board, as you'll learn today, will be acting on the revised template. So a lot of good thinking has gone into that. We've had the opportunity to give feedback from our perspective here in Santa Clara County to those processes and be involved in teams at the state level and have been working hard to calibrate across county offices as well. This is work that we are really committed to, we believe in, and we are here to be of assistance to you. So please don't ever hesitate to pick up the phone and call us. We also believe strongly that one of the benefits of this work was really firming up the partnership between the program side of the house and the business side of the house, that we're both doing good work before this, kind of sometimes in isolation, and this work has brought us together. And my counterpart, Jim Novak, is here in the back, so we like to model that work for you as well. I want to thank Chris Izor, who leads a team. I'm really proud of the team that we have that's doing this work, and I know you'll meet them over the course of the day. So I won't introduce them all now, but I want to personally thank Chris for heading that team up. It is, again, work that we believe in, and we are here to be of assistance to you. So please don't ever hesitate to pick up the phone and call me or Chris if there's something more that we can do to help you. And I just wish a great day for you as we reboot, as restart, reevaluate, and improve. Good things for 2020. So thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, Gary. Okay, so as Gary mentioned, and as you can kind of see on the slide, you know, we early on started marketing this day as the LCAP reboot. Last year we called it Level Up Your LCAP, right? That concept of you have something existing, we're just going to kind of level it up, make it a little bit better, improve upon it. But with the substantive changes to the LCAP template, we're really asking people to rethink their LCAP as that continuous improvement document that tells the story about what they're doing to improve outcomes for students in their district. And this concept of a reboot, when you think of a reboot, maybe you think of like a reboot, a movie. You know, there's always reboots coming out of old movies from the 70s and the 80s, or that concept of taking a piece of technology like your computer or a phone. And why do you reboot it? Because maybe it doesn't work the way that it's supposed to work. And we want to start fresh. We wipe it clean and we start fresh with a brand new reboot. And so that's where that concept came from, and really kind of zeroing in on this opportunity to restart. Let's reevaluate all pieces of our LCAP, and how can we make this better? How can we stay true to the intention of the LCAP? As people continue to come in, we do have some spaces up front, so you're more than welcome. There's some on the periphery too, so I know I'm that same type of person who's like, don't put me right in front. But as we move on, I just want to again acknowledge our county superintendent, Dr. Mary Ann DeWan, and our County Board of Education for their leadership in this work. A couple years ago was when we really started thinking about how do we build out the capacity of our county office to provide this real technical assistance. And over time, the statewide system of support required that the county office serve in a larger role in terms of supporting districts around continuous improvement planning. And so out of that came our division, our Equity and Educational Progress Division, the LCAP Advisory Services, and our Differentiated Assistance Group, who's really all part of that larger statewide system of support. Just for some housekeeping notes, our safety announcement in the event of an emergency, I'll let you know, and what we'll do is we'll just quickly exit the building and we meet in the parking lot out here. If anybody has any questions about that, we have staff around the room, a lot of county office folks. If you could raise your hands just so people know who's county office folk in the room, if you have any questions about safety or where we need to go, we appreciate that. We are video recording this session as well, and we heard from a number of people about, oh, I can only stay for a portion, or I can't make it. And so one of the things that we committed to early on was to record this this morning session, this three-hour training around the LCAP template, and we plan on making it available shortly after today online so that you can access the content and the information if you want to share it with other people. So that we are video recording. You see the little cameras around the room. I also wanted to make sure that I looked good and presentable, so if my collar's up, someone just quickly wave at me. This is probably the most important slide, and you're all going to walk away going, oh, I never knew that. I've been coming to the county office for years. This is how you open these things? It is tricky. Many of you pull on this latch right here, and you go, how come it doesn't open? So this idea is, first you pull out the latch, then you take your thumb and you press on a hinge. It'll pop up this little section just enough for you to open, and now you all have power. The power to open the outlet covers. All right, bookmark that slide, because you're all gonna wanna use that at future trainings. I made that right before we started. Our county office team is made up of a number of different folks who are supporting the LCAP. We have programmatic representation, we have data and assessment representation, we have fiscal representation. We wanted to give you just a quick breakdown of who's on the team, and we'll just have them quickly raise their hands. I've introduced myself. Annie Murphy is one of our coordinators of district support. She's in the back. Sharon Johnson is an additional coordinator of district support here in the middle. Liz Wolf is our director of differentiated assistance, who supports districts and their LCAP as well. Dr. Don River, I thought I saw her come in the back getting coffee. She's our coordinator of state and federal programs. Stephanie Lowe is our lead district business advisor for LCAP. She's in the back, right corner there. Dan Mason is a manager of data and assessment, back corner again, and Deanne Walsh, an additional manager of data and assessment in the back. And we all can take a call. We can all try to answer questions, but we work very closely and very collaboratively here at our county office to make sure that we're providing consistent, credible messaging around the LCAP. Today's agenda, if you take a look, we have breakfast. We'll be out most of the morning. There's food and drinks back there to keep you going. We have a big block of time this morning set aside for the LCAP template training. We'll have a break midway through the morning just for you to catch your breath, because there's a lot of content. I know some of you probably already clicked through the slides and saw over 140 slides. We'll go fast. It's there for you. And then we'll break for lunch. And lunch is a little bit early, but at the same time, we have a grab-and-go kind of concept for lunch. So if you're not interested in eating at 11:30, that's okay. You can grab the box and take it with you. But we'll have about 45 minutes for lunch to just kind of recharge. And then the afternoon is set up in breakout sessions. In your handout or in your folder, you have a flyer that breaks down some of the breakout sessions. But you can see up here the sessions that we have set aside for today. First and foremost, I want to thank all of the presenters who were willing to share and put together a presentation around some of this content that really is geared towards making the LCAP a comprehensive document that's supporting your efforts to improve the system in which you're providing instruction, but also supporting some of the neediest kids. And you'll see there's content there specifically for ELs, content specifically there for students with disabilities, content specifically there for foster youth, and how you might go about. And so at the end, we're actually going to have each of the presenters come up and just do a quick 20 to 30 second plug for their session, so you can kind of get an idea of, like, if I was to sit through that 55 minute session, what are the things that we're going to cover? But we also have provided for you on the table and also on the first slide a Google folder that has all the resources for all of the sessions. And so if you're unable to attend a session, you know that you'll have access to those resources from that session. The first folder inside that larger folder is our general session folder. And so you'll have access digitally to all of the resources that are in your folder, in addition, a copy of the slide deck. And so if you want to open a copy of the slide deck and take notes on it, that's for you as well. Okay? Any questions? In the afternoon also, we know that some of you will probably have burning questions that either come up during the morning session or as you collaborate with people around your table. We're also making available just a drop-in technical assistance room, and that'll be in the Franklin McKinley room during the breakout sessions in the afternoon. And so if you wanted to, you could step out or go into the technical assistance and one-on-one support room. Liz Wolf will be back there, in addition to other staff from our department will be supporting if you have those burning questions or you'd like to get a few things answered related to this morning. So the Franklin McKinley room is actually on the third floor. So you should have all of the content that you need to figure out where you're going this afternoon. Second floor. So it's actually on the second floor. That slide's wrong. As we move into kind of the content for today, I want you to keep a couple things in mind. Long time ago, at the beginning of the year, when we were putting together our training schedule, we were told that the board would adopt an LCAP template in November. And I thought, January is perfect, and we're so far away, people are probably going to be saying, why aren't you doing it sooner? Fast forward to where we are today, and a lot of things got postponed or put off because the State Board of Education really wanted to gather more feedback to make sure that this template is responsive to what they were hearing from the field around some of the pain points in the previous iteration. At the same time, really trying to capture some of the other things that continue to come up. And so technically everything today is in draft. The State Board of Ed posted the content for their agenda for their meeting, which is tomorrow. They posted it the Friday before break. So I had a fun break. But most of the content didn't change significantly from the prototypes that we shared with you. And we have had an opportunity as a team to go out and sit down, and hopefully what you see today is not brand new. If we have had a chance to sit down with your leadership team, we've shared kind of what the prototypes were looking like, so we're hoping that as we go through the specifics, the nitty-gritty stuff today, you're going, okay, that makes sense. We've already kind of talked about that. Today really is a learning session, and there's gonna be a lot of content, and there is no expectation that you will be tested at the end of the day, okay? There's gonna be content where you're gonna feel like, I have to remember this, but that's okay because really, we want you to just kind of lean in and get yourself familiar with the content and information. I always use the term, walk away with just enough information to be dangerous. And so, don't worry if we go over something and you go, I didn't really understand that as deep as I think I should. There's technical assistance available in the afternoon, but at the same time, the real work of writing and supporting you in our LCAPs, this is one day of training. But this is not what we really see our role as. Our role is to be that partner alongside with you, coming out to work with you in your districts, jumping on Zoom calls, taking your phone calls, because these questions are going to come up more when you actually start to get into the work of designing and writing your LCAP. And so know that when you leave today, this is not the only time this information can be shared. If you need us to come back out, share it in a more intimate setting, in your office or something like that, we're more than happy to do that. Just stay engaged with us. We really are here to help as partners in this work.